the hiss of changing pain. Trust in Him who will never leave you. Or what years they bring. I found out in the scriptures too, when mother and father die, then it all, He will take me out. Book of Deuteronomy chapter 2. Book of Deuteronomy chapter 2. Amen. Book of Deuteronomy chapter 2, verse 1 reads these words. Then we turned and took our journey into the wilderness by the way of the Red Sea. And as the Lord spake unto me, we compassed Mount Syria many days. And the Lord spake unto me, saying, ye have compassed this mountain long enough, turn you northward. Just for a few minutes, we're going to talk about we've been going in circles.
Amen. All right.
We've been going in circles. Grass with a flower fades away, but the word of our God is still and will stand forever. We've been going in circles. Oh yes, I'm a child of the 70s. And the other day I was reminded that I was a child of the 70s. Because I was flipping radio stations. And as I was flipping radio stations, there was a group by the name of Friends of Distinction came on the radio. And I heard a song by Jerry Pease, who picked up the pen, and he tells us that he is an ever-rolling wheel without a destination wheel. He's an ever-spinning top, whirling till he drops. He says to us in song, that you give me a little hope, something small to cling to, but you got me going in circles. Thought about that in the spiritual realm as I read the text. Israel now has been going in circles for 38 long years. The question has to be asked, why go in circles for 38 long years? They have something in common with that man that stood at the pool of Bethesda for 38 long years. They were going in circles. 38 women going in circles. 38 springs going in circles. 38 summers going in circles. 38 falls going in circles for a journey that they could have made it in 3 days.
Amen.
But when you lack spiritual preparedness, you got to go in circles till you find yourself totally depending on God.
Amen.
And when you find yourself totally, fully depending on God, He can get you to where you want to go or where He wants to see you when you totally depend on Him.
Amen.
It's too many of us in day and hour, we're trying to lean to our own understanding instead of in all your ways acknowledging Him and let Him direct your path. And now you're going.
That's right,
same thing, year in and year out, day in and day out, going in circles.
Yes, yes.
Because your spirit.
Jews. We see the text and the reason why Israel has been going in circles for 38 years. How do you know, Hill, they've been going in circles 38 years? Glad you asked. Not only were they not spiritually prepared, but they were spiritually troubled by God that was on their side, in their midst, that they did not trust. Amen. How do you know that? Hill kept reading. They complained about war when he led them through war.
Amen.
They complained about rain when he fed them bread from heaven and begged them till they wanted no more. They're looking and serving and worshiping every God a golden calf instead of trusting in that God that let them know 38 years and their shoes never wore out.
Yes.
They're now looking at another God that not only provided bread for them, but provided quail for them. And this is the reason why they're going.
It's
a
Sisters,
this is a solid commentary to make, but it's a true commentary to make. A lot of us are just like Israel. We're going in circles. Because we cannot see the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob making a way for us out of the situation that we're in. When you're spiritually unprepared, or you spiritually don't trust God that brought you so far, He'll have you going in circles. Seeing the same thing day by day.
Word.
Week by week.
Word.
Year by year.
Yeah.
Because you know the devil wanna blind you from seeing the power of the only true and living God. And he blinds you, he'll have you going in circles. And you satisfy going in circles for all these years. Because he got blinders on
you.
Seeing the same rock every day. The same tree every day. Because he got you going in circles. And you can't see that it was God that kept you all this time. You can't see it was God that provided food for you. You can't see it was God that led me by a pillar of cloud by day and a pillar of cloud by night. I can't see it was God that kept on providing for me when my ears and my bone came upon me, the ear of my flesh. They stumbled and they fell, and I couldn't see it because I was going in. What have you going in circles? What is it that has you, Greater Mount Pure, going in circles? That you can't see the power of God. Paul is raising his hand. As Paul raises his hand, he says, I can see his power. And the reason why I can see his power, because I want the world to know that height, nor depth, nor principalities, nor things to come is going to separate me from the love of God. If I can't walk, because he's going to give me to suffer. I pull out my sword and say, I'll die with you till the day of reckoning came. And a little girl saw him warming by the end of his pot. He says, aren't you one that followed Jesus? And he denied going in circles. I got to believe God even though I can't always see it.
Amen.
I might be in a storm in my life right now.
Yeah.
But I got to keep believing God.
That
even though it's storming in my life, I'ma look for the rainbow in the midst of my wrath. I'ma look for God to make a way. Because I still believe what the songwriter said. There's a bright side somewhere. And I'm not going to stop till I find it. Because I don't want to go in
circles.
Israel is going in circles. Moses takes the time out and gives us a short account of Israel's long stay in the wilderness and why it was given. God is not only chastening and chastising Israel by letting them stay these many years in the wilderness, but he's letting them see their imperfections while they're there. All that murmuring against God before they can get into the land flowing with milk and honey. It had to be done away with. All of that unbelief had to be done away with. All of that spiritual unpreparedness had to be done away with. Because God cannot bless you with what he would desire for you to have when all you got on inside of you is unbelief. So he lets you go in circles. Because sometimes taking you the shortcut or taking you the short way may hurt you more than it could help you. Brothers and sisters, sometimes God has to take you the long way in order for you not to get spiritually big headed. Because if he took us, a lot of us, the short way, we wouldn't be in his house this morning. Can I be honest with you? If God blessed you with everything what you want in your heart, and let you have 7 or 8 zeros in the bank, you wouldn't be at Brandon Mount Pilgrim this morning. You'd be on the beach, sitting right next to your beach house.
Yeah.
Sitting on something more than Kool-Aid. And papaya juice. Sometimes he got to give you a slice of time. And take you the long way instead of the short way. Because it'll hurt you more than it'll help. Three things in the text I want you to see and we get ready to get out. You got to see why they're going in the wilderness 38 years. Spiritually unpreparedness leads to God's delay.
Amen.
Well, if you're denying God and the power that he has, what reason do you think he's going to come to your behalf in a hurry?
I don't know.
You're spiritually unprepared. Your trust level has to be so much in God that if he doesn't bless me on money, I'm still looking for it on Tuesday.
That's it.
If he don't give it to me on Tuesday, I'm especially Mary and Martha for me.
Uh-huh.
There, even though every time Jesus was in town, their faith level wasn't where it's at. Because we see how their faith level went down when Jesus didn't come, when they thought he ought to come.
All right.
Listen to what they say. If you would have been where you were supposed to have been at the time you were supposed to be, my brother would never die.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. But you got to know who you're talking to. But you got to look at who you're talking to. I'm the one. That was there.
That's good.
From the foundation
of the
world.
That's good.
I'm the one.
Yeah.
That was there when he said, "Let there be," and there was. I'm the one that was there when he said, "Let us make man in our image and we flew into the breath of life and now became a living soul." God's delay.
Yeah.
You know, it's some things God told me a long time ago that he's going to bless me. And I was looking for it to happen the next day. But it's in delay.
It's in delay.
Sister, you got something before you, but it's in delay. Brother, you got something for you, but it's in delay. Brother, you got something for you. Sister, you got something for you, but it's in delay. Because if I give it to you right now, you mess up with it.
That's right.
If I fixed every last one of your hurts right now, you wouldn't praise me.
All
right. But I've got it in delay. Because the day is coming where everything that bothered me on this side won't bother me on the other side. But it's in delay.
Second thing I see
in the text that has been going in circles for 38 years. I got to move flesh out of the way. Because when flesh is in the way, flesh is always warred against spirit. Scripture says this, we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and high places. And the best place how the devil gets you is in your mind. And he'll have you going in circles in your mind. He'll whisper in your ear. You're going down to that church Sunday after Sunday, week after week, and God don't love you. When the scripture says he so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth on him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. But when the devil is in your ear wrestling with you, you won't hear what the scripture says about you. You'll start believing what the devil says about you, and you'll overcome your flesh and say, "Don't nobody love you? You buy this world alone." And that's a lie from the devil that has your mind thinking that nobody cares about you, but there's somebody that cares.
Yeah.
That sticks closer than a brother. But when the devil is in your mind and in your heart, he'll have you going in circles believing things that's not true.
Yeah.
because he loves to see. But I got to move flesh out the way. And when I move flesh out the way, I just believe the scriptures. Even though I'm going through and I'm walking through the valley of the shadows of death, I'm not going to sprint. I'm not going to take off and run really, really fast. I'm going to take my time. And the reason why I'm going to take my time is because there are some things God wants me to see while I'm going through. What is it that you want me to see while I'm going through? My goodness and my mercy. It's following you. It's following you. Even though you can't see it, and death is denying the power that I possess in your life, if you would just see it, that's why I want you to walk and not run. Because we know that there is that way upon the Lord. He's going to do what? Renew. That's the that we ain't a matter with wings as an eagle. Run and not be weary. Walk and not faint. But I got to move flesh out of the way. How do I move flesh out of the way? Paul puts it this way. I beat myself. How do I beat myself? When I desire to go to Popeye. When I desire to go get some Bluebell. When I desire for some peach cobbler, I turn it away. And the reason why I turn it away is because I'm beating my flesh into subjection. And the reason why I'm beating my flesh in subjection, because I don't want somebody else to be going in circles that's looking at me as a believer. That's why I beat myself.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
When I preach to others,
yeah.
I myself, become a casket. Third thing I see that they did like. They were placed in position, but they're still not ready to go in.
Yeah.
Look at it. 38 years. They were going in circles. And God, with his compassionate self, turned them north. They are on the eve of going in, but they still don't believe God. They're sending spies to see if what God said was so. And all 10 spies come back with the same report. Oh, the land is just what it says in it. It's flowing with milk and honey. The grapes are the size of grapefruits. Oh, everything is lovely over there. But we see the problem. The problem is giants over there. Not only do we see giants over there, we see the sons of Anak. We can't possess the land. Two says, with God, all things are possible. But eight saying we can't make it. Because the only thing they can see is giants and the sons of Anak. And the question has to be asked to bring about Pilgrim today, while we're going in circles, whose report will we believe? Will we believe the majority report of the minority report? Because two with God says we can make it. Two with God says all things are possible. Two with God says whatever may come our way, with God on our side, we can make it. But they're believing the wrong report. When you believe the wrong report, brothers and sisters, because God will not allow unbelief to go into the kingdom. I see his power. When I was over in Egypt,
yeah.
I seen what he did to Pharaoh.
Uh-huh.
Not only did I see what he did to Pharaoh, I seen how he turned the Nile River into blood. I seen how he put flies all over Egypt, frogs all over Egypt. I saw how Janus and Jambres threw down their sword. It turned into a snake. And Moses threw down his rod, and it became a snake. And he ate up Janus and Jambres' snake.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Just to get to the eve of a blessing,
uh-huh,
and say, God, because of giants, I reject what you're trying to give me, because I'm satisfied going in circles. But my brothers and sisters, one thing I can say today is I'm glad,
yes, sir,
that he gave me,
yeah,
another round.
Yes, yes.
I'm glad.
Come on now. Yes.
That he gave me,
yeah,
a roadmap.
Yeah.
I'm glad.
Uh-huh.
That he changed my direction.
Yeah, yeah.
And now I'm no longer going in circles.
Yeah.
But I'm going in the direction that he would have me to go.
Uh-huh.
And my brother and sister, I just believe it's like the song right now. And that he is where he leads, I will follow. And I'll go with him all the way.
Yeah.
I just believe that if he leads me through the garden,
to the top, he'll have me going in the
You're here this morning, and you've been growing in church. And you know what God is trying to do? He's trying to break that chain that has you back.
Might not make the same mistake from the day.